Hey learners, welcome to NEC Graphics. We are here with this detailed course where we'll be discussing everything about Adobe Illustrator. In the previous video, we started the topic of shape tools and we have already discussed the rectangle tool there. If you have missed that tutorial, link is available right here or you can get it from the description of this video. In this lesson, we'll discuss the second shape tool, the rounded rectangle. Long press this rectangle icon and you'll get it here. Now in case you are not able to see this tool, it's because you're seeing the basic version of the toolbar. Simply come to this Edit Toolbar option and set it to Advanced. So now, as the name suggests, this tool helps you to draw a rectangle with round corners. If you're seeing these widgets here, it is because the bounding box feature is on right now. These widgets come really handy to transform the drawn shapes in different ways. But I'll discuss the bounding box and its other features in a separate tutorial. For now, I'm going to hide it from this view menu. Or you can go for Ctrl-Shift-B. Now here you must know that the roundness of these corners can be controlled while you are drawing the shape. Just press up or down arrow keys on your keyboard to increase or decrease its roundness value. But remember that it will work only when you are still drawing the shape, which means that you have not released the mouse button yet. Once the shape is drawn, you'll have to explore transformation options to bring any changes to it. In previous lesson, if you remember, I told you about the use of Shift key to control the proportions of the drawn shapes. Here, pressing Shift key while drawing will equally proportion the width and height value of this rectangle. See here. To make a center outward rectangle, press Alt key while you click on the artboard. Now the rectangle will be drawn taking your point of click as center. You can press Shift and Alt keys together also to make a perfect square from center. While you're drawing the shape, you can press spacebar and drag it to the desired spot. Now let's see how you can put in specific values for your rectangle. Simply click on the artboard. Dialog box appears. Here you have these width and height fields to enter your specific values and you can also set the corner radius here. That is how round you want the corners to be. Here you have got this constrain button. We use it to constrain the proportion of our dialed up values. Say I want a rectangle having width 3 times higher than its height value. For that, I'll dial 3 in the width column and 1 in the height column and I'll turn this constrain button on. Now the proportion of width and height has been fixed to 3:1. Now dial any value for height and width by itself will get adjusted to 3 times higher value. You can also draw a centered outward rectangle with specific values. For that you have to press Alt key before clicking on the artboard. Remember that you have to keep Alt key pressed when you click. Now put in the values and rectangle will be drawn taking your point of click as center. And that's all about the rounded rectangle. Stay tuned for the next lesson on everything about the ellipse tool. Thanks for watching NEC Graphics. Goodbye for now.